In display technology, contrast is one of the most important image quality metrics because it allows us to distinguish the content of an image regardless of the brightness of that image. Contrast is the difference between two images or two image components, quantified as a ratio, hence the term contrast ratio. Contrast ratio has no unit, but it's typically written with a colon to indicate that it is a ratio, for example, 1000:1. When measuring the black and white light levels to calculate an image's contrast ratio, in addition to determining these two levels, you also need to measure external elements such as ambient and stray light. Images displayed by projectors or shown on LCD displays are typically formed by two components: a uniform and bright white light source and a spatial light modulator that contains the pixels and generates the images. The light source can be constant or modulated in brightness. The pixels create the detailed spatial and temporal filtering. The contrast ratio measured in a perfectly dark room is different from what is measured in an actual setup. Did you know that even black paint has a reflection of approximately 5%? Throughout this video, just keep in mind that a perfectly dark room can only be achieved in a laboratory. In a real setup, stray light and ambient light affect the contrast ratio. In a perfectly dark room, there is no ambient light to impact the contrast ratio. When source modulation is used as well, there is also no stray light. Independent of the white brightness, the full-on, full-off contrast ratio would always be infinite because we are dividing by zero in the formula. For example, in the case of luminance values of 1000 nit and noise values on the measurement devices resulting in a minimal detectable luminance of 0.001 nit, we would measure a contrast ratio of 1,000,000 to 1. The second example again shows the contrast ratio measured in a dark room, but without using a full-screen white and full-screen black test pattern. Instead, a checkerboard pattern is used. So, stray light now affects the measurements as well. Light intended for the white zones also falls onto the black zones. When we take a realistic value of 2 nit of stray light, the contrast ratio drops to 400:1. ANSI uses this method, with a 4x4 checkerboard test pattern in its definition of contrast ratio. At Barco, we also measure contrast ratio in this way. The following scenario is not in a dark room. This is a typical system setup, with changing light conditions that can vary from dim light to office lighting to bright sunlight. As this ambient light falls onto the display, it has an impact on the contrast ratio. Ambient light can vary from a few nit in a dimly lit room to about 100 nit in normal office lighting to over 1,000 nit in direct sunlight. When we take a conservative ambient light level of 50 nit, the actual system contrast ratio drops to 21:1, even when we use full screen black and white and source modulation. Our final example still shows a typical system setup, but without full-screen black and white. In this case, the stray light impacts the image again and the contrast ratio drops to 20:1. Note that the relative impact of the ambient light is much bigger than that of the stray light and the light coming from the source modulation. This illustrates the importance of a well-designed total system. To conclude, even though contrast ratio is one of the most important image quality metrics, it is the hardest one to quantify in an objective and representative way. The examples we've shown highlight the impact of parameters such as source modulation, stray light, and ambient light. When you see terms like dynamic contrast or dynamic range, understand that source modulation is being used. Sequential contrast means that full screen black and white are used. At Barco, we use the ANSI contrast with a 4x4 checkerboard test pattern, whereas other manufacturers often use sequential contrast. We hope this educational video has helped you to better understand where the differences in contrast ratios from different suppliers come from.